Hey friends, welcome again to another session on number system. And in this session, we are going to discuss conversion of decimal numbers into rational numbers of the form PYQ. Now, there are two possibilities here. One is we have either terminating decimal, for example, like 0.5, and hence you have to convert into a form of PYQ. Otherwise, you have a recurring non-terminating decimal representation like 0.3 bar, and that you have to convert into PYQ. Now, non-terminating recurring decimal itself can be of two types. One is pure non-terminating, that is, all the digits after the decimal are repeating, like 0.3 bar. On the other hand, it can be mixed non-terminating recurring as well. Mixed. So, take note of these words, these terms, pure and mixed. So, pure is all the digits are repeating, but mixed is only few, not all are repeating basically. So, example 0.23333, right? Or 0.23 bar. Now, in this session, we are going to take up only the A case A, this one. And in the subsequent sessions, we'll take up case B. Okay. Now, let us do it through examples, and also we will write the algorithm. So, first step is count the number of digits after the decimal point. So, in this case, I have taken a first example as 5.67. So, the number of digits after the decimal is 2, isn't it? Now, remove the decimal. So, hence, after you remove the decimal, you will be left with 5.67. And then you simply divide the number obtained by 1 followed by number of zeros obtained in 1. So, now how many zeros we obtained? 2, right? Number of digits obtained after decimal is 2. So, you'll have to divide the number so obtained in step number 2 by 1 followed by those many zeros. So, if you see, I'm dividing 5, 6, 7 by 1 followed by 2 zeros. Why 2 zeros? Because 2 digits were there after the decimal point. So, 567 by 100. And you have to reduce it to the most simplest form if it is possible, right? In this case, it is not reducible because there is 567 is neither a multiple of 2 nor a multiple of 5, so it cannot be reduced further. Another example is, let us say I have to take 0.75. So, how many digits after the decimal? Again, 2. So, you have to remove the decimal part from 0.75, you will get 75, and then divide by 1 followed by 2 zeros, which you can see here. And if you reduce it, you will get 3 by 4. So, ultimately, you'll have to reduce it to the most simplest form of the fraction. Let us say instead of 0.75, we had 0.705, 10 in between 75. How many digits after the decimal you can see count? 1, 2, 3, isn't it? So, remove the decimal to get 705 and divide now it by 1000. And if you simplify, both are multiples of 5, denominator and numerator. So, hence in the top, you'll get 141 divided by 200 in the denominator. This is the most simplest form. And finally, I've taken another example where it is 2.5600, right? So, 2.5600, how many digits after decimal? 4. So, after removing the decimal, the number is 25600, and I have divided by 1 followed by 4 zeros because 4 digits were there after the decimal. So, finally, it is 256 by 100, which is reduced to 64 upon 25. Now, you also know that 2.5600 can also be written simply as 2.56. So, you don't need to count the last 2 zeros in the number. So, hence, it is simply 256 upon 1 followed by 2 zeros. Why 2 zeros? Because there were 2 digits after the decimal. It is reduced to further 64 upon 25. So, I hope you learned how to convert a terminating decimal form into a PYQ form. In the subsequent sessions, we'll see how to convert a non-terminating recurring decimal representation, both mixed as well as pure form, into rational number of the form PYQ. Thank you.